Morning, my dear students. Good morning to all of you. So let's begin our class. Yes. So do you know, children, what we have learned in the previous class? Yes, it's about salt. We all know that salt is very important, right? Yes. And we know that Indians were making the salt on the seashore. But the British told the Indians to pay tax for the salt. So the Gandhiji protested against it. Gandhiji was against it, and this led to the fight. Mass violence means it led to the fight between the Indians and the British. Gandhiji told that we can't pay tax because we Indians are making the salt. So we can't pay tax. But British was not willing to hear that, and so the violence became, the fight became between the British and the Indians. So what did Gandhiji did? Gandhiji protested against this by a Dandi March. This Dandi March, it happened on 12th March 1930. So in the morning, in the Sabarmati Ashram, all woke up early, and all the leaders, everyone including Jawaharlal Nehru and Sarojini Naidu, all were gathered at the Dandi seashore. And you know what happened, children? Gandhiji, along with his followers and all the people from Sabarmati Ashram, followed Gandhiji from Sabarmati Ashram to the Dandi seashore of Gujarat. And before he was going to the Dandi seashore, Gandhiji said one thing. You know what he said? I will return to this Sabarmati Ashram only if I win. Otherwise, I will offer my body to the seashore. So this is the wording said by Gandhiji. What does it mean? That is, he will return to the Sabarmati Ashram only if he win it, if he win against this salt law. Otherwise, he will die in the seashore. So Gandhiji, along with his followers, walked long distance, about 388 kilometers they walked in the hot sun towards the Dandi seashore of Gujarat. And when he reached there, there was a huge crowd surrounding him. And in front of that crowd, he took a handful of salt. You can see from the picture. He took a handful of salt and he raised his hand and said, "This salt is the symbol of strength. This is our strength. We should fight against the salt law." So this is what he said. And also he said, the fist. Fist means holding the hands like this. This is called fist. So I told you, he took a handful of salt in his hands and he folded like this. And he said that the salt inside this may be crushed. It may be broken into pieces. But we will stand against the salt law. The salt will be our symbol of strength. So this is what Gandhiji said. Okay. And this violation in the salt, against the salt tax, begin another movement called civil disobedience movement. The civil disobedience movement was started by the Indian National Congress under the leadership of Gandhiji. The main aim of the civil disobedience movement was to get rid of the salt tax. That is, the British had made many laws. Right, so to get rid of it, that was the aim of the civil disobedience movement. They don't want to pay the tax for the salt because Indians are making it. So why should they pay the tax? This was the question of Gandhiji. So all the Indians was against such a salt tax law. Clear? Now, next one is about Kerala and salt satyagraha. The salt satyagraha also happened in Kerala. You can see this poem, children. I mean, this is a song which is familiar song in Kerala, which was sung by the people in Kerala. If you sing this song, they feel very happy, enthusiastic means they feel very happy. I think all might have heard this song. What is the song? Variga variga sahadare valiya sahana samaramai. I think all might have heard this song. So this song, when they sing this song, they feel happy inside. And they feel that they are doing something for the freedom struggle. Okay? And the salt satyagraha also was there in Kerala. Okay? And those leaders who stood against this were many. K. Kelappan was the main leader to protest against the salt law. Okay, so he was later known as Kerala Gandhi. K. Kelappan was later known as Kerala Gandhi. He was the leader of that, who stood against the salt tax law. And many other leaders from Kerala took part in the freedom struggle. See, you can see from the picture, that is, besides K. Kelappan, T. K. Madhavan, Muhammad Abdul Rahman, K. P. Kesava Menon, A. K. Gopalan, Akkamma Cheriyan, Kuttimalu Amma, these were the main leaders who took part in freedom struggle from Kerala. So as a result of this, many leaders, including Gandhiji also was there at the time of the salt law, protest against the salt law in Kerala. So many leaders, including Gandhiji, British arrested them and brutally they were punished. They were punished very severely. The British punished them very severely. Some has to sacrifice their life. Many lost their life with this. So this all happened during the salt satyagraha. That is during the violation against the salt law. And in your textbook, there is other question. Which are the similar protests which took place in Kerala? This same protest like Dandi March. There were other protests in Kerala, that was Malabar Rebellion, Vaikkam Satyagraha, Guruvayur Satyagraha. So this were the similar protests which happened in Kerala. Okay, just you want to know the names of it, that's it. Now next one is Quit India Movement. Quit India means leave India. So Jawaharlal Nehru presented this in the Congress section which is held in Mumbai. Okay, so it was under the leadership of Gandhiji. Gandhiji's slogan was that do or die or quit India. What is the meaning of that? We will free India from the British or we will die. If British are not willing to go from India, we will die or we will free from India. So this was the slogan, do or die, and British has to leave India. So Quit India started on 9th August. Okay, it was started on 9th August. And there were many leaders, you can see from the picture, the many leaders who took part in the freedom struggle, that is Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Bala Gangadhara Tilak, Subhash Chandra Bose, Gopala Krishna Gokhale, Bhagat Singh, Sarojini Nayaru, Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan, Dr. S. Rajendra Prasad, Maulana Abdul Kalam Azad. So this were the other freedom fighters who took part in the freedom struggle. So as a result of their sacrifice, their hard work, India finally got independent on 15th August 1947. So this was due to their main sacrifice for our country. So you have to understand, children, this much struggle, because British were brutally, they were punishing, they were beating them without any sympathy. They were beating them very harshly, and many were, including Gandhiji, has put them in the jail, were arrested by this British. So after sacrificing such hardships, India got independent under the leadership of Gandhiji on 15th August 1947. So this is about the lesson. So today we have discussed about Dandi March and the Dandi March which happened in Kerala, and it was happened in Payyanur seashore in Kannur. Okay, it was happened in Payyanur seashore in Kannur, and the main leader who was protesting against this was K. Kelappan. Clear? Yes. So that's why he was known as Kerala Gandhi. And then we learnt about Quit India movement. Quit India means leave India. What is the slogan, children? Do or die. We will free India or otherwise we will die. This is the slogan of this Quit India movement. So hope you have understood this lesson. Okay. So let us assess, we will discuss during the class discussion time. So till then, bye.